بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بعد الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه ثم أما بعد. Today's topic is about الصبر, patience, to be patient to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Why do you have to be patient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you, you have to know that Allah is going to test you. Test you in your money. Test you in your children. Test you in your health. Test you in your business. So if you have a problem or trouble in one of these, you have to know that it's a test from Allah. To test what? To test your patience, your sabr. Will you be patient or will you not be patient? And that's why, if you are patient, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in one verse, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّ الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. On the judgment day, if you are patient in this life and you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the judgment day, Allah gonna give you what? Give you reward until you tell Allah, oh Allah, I don't need more. I'm satisfied now. That's enough. Because of what? Because you were patient in this life. And listen to this authentic hadith. At Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there was a Muslim woman. This woman had to have epilepsy, something like coma, sara. She used to fall on the road, had epilepsy. So she didn't, you know, feel anything around her. And when she had this coma, she used to have her clothes up her body and she was nearly naked. So some people told her, why don't you go to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and asking him to make dua for you to be cured from this sickness or disease? Then she went to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and gave him salam and told the Prophet Muhammad, oh Prophet Muhammad, I had this kind of sickness and I want you to make dua for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure me, to heal me. Then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was about to make dua for her to be cured. Then he stopped and told her a question. Would you like to be patient? What does it mean? Means she's gonna have the disease, she's gonna have epilepsy, she's gonna have coma. Would you like to be patient for this disease? And I guarantee heaven, Jannah for you. You see, if she's gonna be patient, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam gonna guarantee heaven for her. So the woman thought a little bit. Then she said, yes, Prophet Muhammad, I would like to be patient, to have this sickness, and you guarantee heaven for me. Then she left Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But she came back after 1 minute and told the Prophet, oh Prophet, but I want you to make me another dua, another supplication. Prophet Muhammad asked her, what's this? She told him, oh Prophet Muhammad, I want you to make dua that when I have this epilepsy, you know, I got naked a little bit. So make dua for me not to get naked, so my clothes cover my body. Okay, so she's gonna have the epilepsy, but without getting naked. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam made dua for her to have this disease, but without being naked in front of other people, even a little bit. And after that, the companion said that this woman used to have this sickness on the way. She used to fall down and have this epilepsy, but without being naked. Her clothes covered her because of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam supplication, dua. And then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told his companions, if anyone wants to look at someone from heaven, someone from heaven is between you, is with you now, look at this woman. This woman is already going to be in heaven and she is still being with us now. So this is the reward if you are patient with sickness, with losing your money or your son. And listen to the other hadith. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in this authentic hadith, hadith Qudsi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send his angels to take the soul. Okay, they're gonna take the soul of a small boy, a very small boy. Then they're gonna take his soul. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask his angels, what did his dad do? What did his mom say? Then the angels, Allah knows, but he is, you know, teaching us. Then the angels are gonna answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying that his dad and the mom said, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. We are coming from Allah and we are going back to Allah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask his angels, because of this, because they were patient, they said إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. I ask you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gonna ask his angel to put the boy in heaven. This is the first reward. And the second reward, to build a palace. Where? In this life? No, in heaven. For his mom and the dad, subhanallah, because they are patient. They didn't keep, you know, screaming, saying, why us, only us? No, they were patient to Allah. And they know it's a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded them. Number one, their son is in heaven. Number two, they're going to have a palace, big palace for them in heaven on the judgment day. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وجزاكم الله خيرا.